A lot of web developers are using AI applications such as chat assistants or code assistants. But building an AI application yourself can sound like a scary task. But it's not as complex as you think. In this video, I'm going to walk you through how you get from asking a question to retrieving an answer by a large language model. There are a couple of patterns in between. So let's break down what a typical AI application looks like. Often it starts with a user interface. In a user interface, you can ask your questions. The user interface will then connect to a library or a framework. This library or framework could be open source or it could be a cloud product. This library or framework will interact with an API, and this API is typically provided by an LLM provider. As mentioned, there are a couple of patterns I'd like to highlight. Usually people start by asking a question to a large language model. This question will be put inside of a prompt. Then this prompt will be sent to the large language model and retrieve your final answer. So in your prompt, you would put both your question, but also a set of instructions for the LLM, such as be a helpful assistant or don't hallucinate or don't offend anyone. There's also a more complex pattern next to basic prompting. And this is what we call RAG, or retrieval augmented generation. Again, it starts with a question. This time your question won't be directly put inside a prompt, but it will be turned into an embedding. This embedding will then be used by a vector database to find relevant context. So this vector database is right here. And with this vector database, you can retrieve relevant context. We call this top end matches. These top end matches will be put inside a prompt. And this prompt will, of course, also contain your question. What the LLM sees is your prompt, which includes both the question and the top end matches. And based on this, it's going to return your final answer. With RAG, there is also a stage where you upload your data into the vector database. And this is important because otherwise the vector database won't be able to retrieve alien relevant context. If we look at basic prompting, this is typically done via an API or an SDK, which could be provided by the LLM provider. If we look at RAG, or retrieval augmented generation, you typically do this via a library or a framework. So the final pattern you can implement as a web developer when building your AI application is AI agents. With AI agents, you still have a question and a final answer. But this time you have an agent in the middle that will help you to answer the question. So we start again with a question. This time your question will be sent to the agent. There are multiple patterns to implement agents, and typically you use a framework or a library to do this. The agent will typically plan based on your question and the available tools. It will act or react based on the tool calls. And then finally, it's going to reflect and see if your answer is matching the question. For the plan and act stage, it needs a set of tools. And these tools could be either APIs, databases, or code, for example, to crawl the web. The LLM is going to use those tools to plan and execute, and finally providing you with your final answer. Next to a single agent, you can also have a multi-agent framework. This typically involves a supervisor agent, which is going to determine which agent should be called to answer your question. So in this video, we looked at three different patterns to implement AI applications. The first one was basic prompting, where you use a prompt, which includes your question and a set of instructions. The second one was RAG, or retrieval augmented generation, where we use a vector database to make LLMs context aware of your data. And the final one was agents, where you use an agent that will look at a set of tools, and based on the tools, is going to answer your question. So with this, I hope you can start building your AI applications today.